Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So today I won't be actually working with a vacuum, but rather I'll be working with something that was in the vacuum chamber last week. You see, many people wanted to know, did the rocket actually completely burn while it was under vacuum? I'm actually rather curious of this myself. From the video, it looked like the ejection charge of this one did not fire. Here's one that burned in the atmosphere, and I can actually already see, you might be able to even see through it, that all of the powder has in fact burned. But to see that for this one, I might have to cut the bottle off. So let me get working on that. All right, so there's the bottle removed. And there's the motor. Now, you can see I did have some glue in here, because I glued it into the bottle. Now, the question is, did this glue stop the charge from exploding out the front and cause it to go out the back, and I just didn't notice it, or did the charge fire at all? And to find that out, I'm going to have to cut this whole thing open lengthwise. So, all right, so I didn't do a tremendous job of cutting these open. You can see most of the insides have been busted apart, but you can still see what happened here. So this is the one that burned in the vacuum, this is the one that burned in the atmosphere, and this is the one that didn't get a chance to burn at all. It slammed into the side wall of the chamber when this one burned. So if we look at this, this is one that burned in the vacuum. You can see that the main part of the fuel grain is gone, just like it is over here. In fact, this should be turned like that. Yeah, so this is with them all lined up. So this one had the fuel grain burn out. You see the burnt gunpowder in here. Same thing you can see in here, and the pieces of the nozzle that are strewn throughout. And you can see the intact fuel grain here. Now on top of the fuel grain, you can see a little bit different colored material. This is the delay grain. This is powder that has stuff mixed in with it to make it burn slowly, so as to have a delay before it fires the ejection charge. The ejection charge you can see over here is this dark material that is above the delay grain. And this one, it's all burned out. This one, it looks like a lot of that was actually busted out when it slammed into the side of the chamber and was ruined. But here you go. So this delay charge here is completely intact inside the one that burned in the vacuum. This tells me that the main fuel grain burned out. When it hit this, the fire was slower, and therefore it didn't build up as much pressure and couldn't sustain itself burning, and so it went out. And then that was it for this motor. So there you go. The motor did not burn completely, but all of the actual thrust-producing fuel grain did burn. So what appears to have happened is the bottle, which was surrounding this rocket, burned off very quickly after this one ignited. But once this was ignited, it was able to maintain pressure inside the chamber and continue burning the fuel. And the bottle, you know, continued to burn away, and then it zipped around the chamber. Then, once the main fuel grain was burned out, the pressure dropped, the gases escaped, and then the motor went out. So a lot of people brought up the point that I was kind of cheating, you know, the motor was burning inside of a pressurized bottle with oxygen and stuff. Well, first of all, oxygen really doesn't matter. These motors have their own oxygen supply inside. And second of all, the bottle was only there for a very short amount of time. By the time this motor got burning, the back of this bottle was gone. And also, it wouldn't have produced thrust if the bottle was containing everything. So, there you go. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time. So here's a piece of the fuel grain from the motor. You can see it burns very rapidly. And here's a piece of the delay grain, the stuff that causes the delay between the fuel grain and the ejection charge. You can see that stuff burns much more slowly. That was not able to maintain enough pressure to keep burning inside the vacuum chamber.